Welcome back, everyone. I'm Raz, and I have a deep connection to this place. I've lived here for 5 years before. Today, I'm gonna go deep and talk to the people. I'm going to see families of police officers. I'm going to see school officers. I'm going to really give you guys an inner look about the lives and the people behind all this mess that you met.
I came to Hong Kong in 2010. The first time I came, it was a really safe and prosperous city, and the people here are very, very friendly. At first, I can't speak Cantonese, and they teach me how to say, and the neighborhood are so nice. And recently, people don't really talk to you. Well, my kids went to school. We have to wait over 40 minutes for the bus, maybe because many people are scared of the disruption that happened in MTR, so they choose to take bus. Before, it's like 2 minutes, 5 minutes.
So yeah. Life really changed dramatically in the last few months, huh?
Yes, and you know, my husband is a policeman, and I have to be really, really careful. Recently, I warned him that over 1,000 policemen's information was leaked.
Oh my God.
So I have to warn him that you have to stop posting your kids' photos on Facebook. Mr. like his Facebook, how many kids he had, where they go to school,
oh
and
my God.
His wife, and it's really, really terrible. One of my friends, belongs to PTU, his phone number was leaked out, and every morning the bad people will call him. They'll call him like, oh, you ordered 100 bath tap. Every morning they start to harassment, like every civil people and educated people won't do that. We have to avoid talking to those people whose opinions are different from you, because you don't know what they will do. As a reporter from China, and he said, I support Hong Kong police, you can beat me now. One of my policeman friends, he cried as well. He said, sorry, this young man, you are very brave and a hero, but we cannot arrest the protesters at that time. It's like there's no law, you know. A lot of people asking, where's the policeman? Because the protesters, there are so many people, the policemen cannot get in. Even they refuse the ambulance to get in. If you support the police, you will be isolated from your friends, and they will give you a lot of evidence that but protesters was arrested. But so, what I think is the arrestment is fine because you're breaking the law.
Yeah.
I just want him to come home safely. That's all. He really, really has to work. It's like he's absent at home, and he has to work really, really long time. Like sometimes it's like 20 hours a day. I think the world should know that Hong Kong police is very, very strong, and they are very strong, willing to protect the city. I think they're the most professional police crew in the world. So I believe in them, they won't quit their job. No matter what happens outside, they will still protect the city if they still can.
Are you proud of your husband and his colleagues?
Yes, of course. Recently, they are very disappointed, but still, they know what their job are and they will stick to it.
You and the people like me who support the police, we get mentally beaten every day.
Yes.
By these things. It hurts us so much to see this.
Yeah, we will be fine.
Okay.
Hopefully.
You like this? I arrived at a local Hong Kong high school. Recently, the protests, the social unrest of Hong Kong, has impacted so many sectors of society that even the education system, the first day of school, was impacted when many people didn't show up. When I heard this, I was extremely shocked. Got the time of a friend of mine who is a principal in a local high school here. I really gotta figure out what's going on. I really wanna know. Hi.
Hi.
Thank you so much for letting me
Welcome.
Come and see the
Welcome
school.
Welcome to our school.
Congratulations on the new beginning of the new year, just on Monday, right?
Yeah, just on Monday. All students and teachers are taking the lessons regularly.
I'm concerned about the life of the students and the teachers.
Yeah. Most of the students show up in
show up.
Teachers and students feel worried. Maybe the internet atmosphere or the society's atmosphere gives more and more pressure and more and more anxiety information to our students and teachers.
Yeah.
I feel very stressful. I'm quite worried about our students. Maybe some students with some emotional problem, every day the multimedia show a lot of photos or videos about negative action. Young people always have a lot of passions rather than reasons. Go to the front line to take some extreme action rather than to just sit down to listen to the teachers or social workers talk about this thing, this crisis, what happening.
Yeah.
I try to transfer our students' focus into the school life, school teaching and learning, rather than to worry about the society crisis, the social crisis. This is not a student's business. It's very important for anyone, including students, learn to how to think independently, how to critically think.
The conversation with the principal really brought a lot of questions up to me. All the way up to the education, negativity, influenced by others, and they're not putting attention to school. Don't let this violence rise. Don't let this misleading information impact your life as a student, as a teacher, as a parent. One thing my parents taught me, and I'm sure every person watching this video, he agrees to this, that education is number one. We don't want our society to break, especially our education system and our children. We don't want them to be broken.